Good morning. And happy Epiphany. You know, this first Sunday in January, we always do the Epiphany play, but only on a few occasions does it actually land on Epiphany. So may the force be with us. And for those of us who have been at rehearsals, we know that's a joke. So listen, because there's some fun things in this play today. Again, I want to thank the Reeds for doing all the hard lifting and directing this year, and for the children and the adults and everybody who stepped in to make this happen, and for the parents at home who rehearse lines with their kids. The script is not in your bulletin so that we can just get out of our heads and watch our children enact this story. Some of them are great at speaking out loud, some of them aren't. So what we're being invited to do as a congregation is be as still as possible so we can hear them. Lynn has worked really hard with them, but they're doing their best, and it's going to be great. In your bulletin are all the hymns you'll need, so we don't have to go back and forth. So when it's time, Josh will just start playing because he has the script. There are two typos, so my apologies for that. If people can figure out which ones they are, I'll give you a little prize. I don't know, you know. There was a retired priest's wife when I was in Concord as a new priest at St. Paul's. And after every service, she'd come up to the rector and hand him a bulletin. And it was circled in red, all the typos that they had missed. So. Oh, well. And David, the rector, would say, "I'm so glad you enjoyed worship today." So, well, our opening hymn is not 6 as in the hymnal, but 7. Christ whose glory fills the skies. And when we sing the carols during the play, we'll just stay seated. So just so you know that. Otherwise, it's going to be really, we're going to get head rushes. So, but for this, let us stand. Christ whose glory fills the sky, hymn 7. In the Red Book of Common Prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
And now for the Epiphany play. Please be seated. And you guys.
Good morning. In this holy season, we celebrate good news of great joy. God has sent his Son to live among us and fulfill his purpose. Hear the words of the prophet Isaiah, foretelling the birth of the Messiah and the coming of God's kingdom. A holy child will be born from God's family as the prophets foretold, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, and the Spirit of knowledge and awe to the Lord. And his delight shall be in love of the Lord. He shall not judge but as what his eyes see, or decide but what his ears hear. But what his compassion, he shall judge the poor and stand up for the meek of the earth, and pass the judgment upon the wicked. The Holy One to come will be dressed in faithfulness and loving kindness. And when he arrives, the wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the lion and fatling together. And the little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall feed, the young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The baby shall play in safety over the hole of the snake, and the toddler shall put its hand into the snake's den without harm. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
Thank you.
angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a maiden betrothed, a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and that maiden's name was Mary. And the angel has departed from her. In those days, a decree went out from Governor Caesar Augustus, that all people of his country shall be counted, and all went back to the city of their birth. Joseph traveled with Mary from the city of Nazareth to Judea to the city of David, which is now called Bethlehem. Because he was a family of the King David, he went to be counted with Mary, his fiancée at the time, who was going to have a baby. Soon, Mary gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in rags and laid him in a feeding trough called a manger in this example, because there was no place for him in the inn.
Ave Maria, Ave Maria, Now, in that region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night, and trying to fix the World Series trophy.
Hey guys, what are you doing? You're supposed to be watching the sheep.
But boss, we should be proud of this trophy.
Yeah, boss, it's broken.
And I even brought flex tape.
Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them.
What is it, guys?
Holy guacamole!
What is it, guys?
Is it Penny Marshall?
Is it Aretha Franklin?
Is it Stan Lee?
Stan Lee?
No, Stan Lee.
I said that.
And suddenly there was with the angel a choir of heavenly host praising God and saying,
praise the Lord and sing a happy song.
They said he's in a stable in Bethlehem.
Let's go find him. Can you call him Uber?
the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. They told them what the angel had said about the child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Mary remembered all these things and thought deeply about them. It is written in the book of Isaiah, "Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will be seen upon you, and nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising." Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Bethlehem. For they had seen his star shining in the east, and it had come to rest over the place where the Christ child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. They realized that the King of Kings had been born in the world. The wise men entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother.
Oh,
Then they worshiped the Christ child, and opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Hail, newborn Prince of Peace. Hail, King of Kings. I offer you the gift of gold.
Hail, Lord of Heaven. I offer you the gift of frankincense.
Hail, King of Kings. I offer you the gift of myrrh. Susan, what is for you?
And Mary, his mother, kept all these memories, pondering them in her heart. For upon seeing that even the kings of great nations bowed down to the newborn Jesus, she knew that God had kept the promise of old. God is and will be with us always.
Yes, and as they make their exit, we will continue with the prayers of the people.
The prayers of the people follow Form 4. And can be found on page 388 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy, give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy, bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. for all known to us who celebrate birthdays this week, including Maureen Lee, Angie Batty, Jill Exner, Travis Brown, and Stephen Fry. And for those celebrating anniversaries this week, including Frank and Nancy Lockwood. Lord, in your mercy, comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. We pray for all who work for peace worldwide, for those for whom our prayers for healing and encouragement are asked today. Chris, Kyle, Cletus, Ruth, Nancy, Gail, Corrine, Lexis, Emily, John, Judith Ann, Richard, Lloyd, Aaron, Eileen, and Pat. And for healing within ourselves and for those in our thoughts and hearts today. Lord, in your mercy, we commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. From our Book of Remembrance, Shirley Mae Simons-Pritzky, Mary Ackerley, Phyllis Marie Kempf Phipps, and Carolyn Sally Healy. Lord, in your mercy.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Since we have little angels trying to get in here, let us stand for the peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you, Paul. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Please know that all people of faith are welcome to receive communion at our altar rail. We have gluten-free wafers for those who need it. And if you'd like to come forward for a blessing instead of communion, you can just cross your hands over your chest and I'll know to give you a blessing as well. And if you'd like to remain in your pew during communion, that's perfectly okay. All are welcome to come, but don't feel bad if you would prefer not to. Walk in love as Christ loves us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. continue with Eucharistic Prayer B, found on page 367. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for all, for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. And in the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Thank you. the people of God. Please come.
Thank you.
Before we pray the post-communion prayer, I'll just say a prayer. Happy Beal is going to be taking communion over to the Hillsborough County Nursing Home, to Barbara, and hopefully to Frank Tibbetts as well. So let us pray. Gracious God, as you gather us in to strengthen and nourish us, may we go forth to nourish others, and especially Happy as she brings the sacraments to Barbara and to Frank this week. May they know that even though they can't be with us physically, that we are with them in spirit and that our love is always with them. Amen. Thank you, Happy. And now using the prayer on page 365, let us pray together. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and remain with you always. Amen. A few announcements before our closing hymn. First of all, if you're visiting us today on this special occasion of the Epiphany play, we're glad you're here. We hope that you felt welcome in our worship. And if you want to find out more, you're welcome to fill out a little pew card that's in your pew rack there. That's how we can get to know you and you can get to know us. If you give us your email, we'll put you on the parish news email that's once a week and you can hear all about us. And if you want, you can also get our newsletter. And if you have any things you'd like from us, just write it in there and we'll make sure to respond. Also, with the Community Clothing Center, they have some volunteer slots that really need to be filled. And so if anyone is at all interested in maybe learning more about it, one is on the fifth Saturday morning of the month. So it's like, you know, how often is that, right? Not a big deal, but they really need people. So see Joan Elaine you find out more about it. We'd love to have you volunteer. Also, our annual meeting is at the end of this month on the 27th after church. We hope you all can be there. It's a time when we present the budget, we share blessings of the year, and the delegates, the vestry people who are running, and the delegates and alternate for convention are posted downstairs and also at the back as is needed. Are there any other announcements? Lene, then Angie.
This Thursday,
oh, yes. Yes, so we're looking really forward to that. We're trying to, we know how crazy life is, so we want to provide childcare and a meal for you. So all you got to do is show up and learn from each other. So, Lene, thank you so much for that.
Speaking of food, making the fourth annual meeting that is hot up, so we're in your tradition.
All right. All right, our closing hymn is 65. Prepare the way, O Zion. And again, a thank you to the Reeds and to all the kids who did it. A huge thank you to the Reeds. Yeah. Woohoo! And to whoever were the camel.